of even the knowledge of such existence, for that overwhelmed, and those devotees who are there toasted and roasted in divine ecstatic trance, for those people, Yudhishthira, I have appointed 3 crores of rishis known as Valkyrias, saying the Gotra, Sutra, name, as well as the nakshatra of these people, those who are highly preoccupied in spiritual transcendentality, Yudhishthira, they are going to perform all the spiritual rites which are meant for these people. Takkarma te prakurvanti tisrakotyo maharshaya. Those who are preoccupied due to divine transcendentality, that's what I am saying. Those who are working for culture, those who are working for the renaissance of the nation and its glory, those who are working for the religion and its upliftment, those who are working for the applied religious and philosophical implementation for a contemporary, competitive, futuristic society, such a warrior, such a brave person, such an intellectually obedient person who is a divine soldier, for him, those who are preoccupied by means of this type of extraordinary divine service, all of the regular religious duties are performed by specially appointed rishis who are meant for that. Not due to other reasons, I have already told, Abhishwasa, Ashwadha, Raksha, those people are punishable. Whereas these people, they have been specially capped with a god like that. So, appointment of some special rules and some speciality that gives the divine mercy. Those who are meant exclusively for divinity, they have to take their livelihood, the whole time vision of chanting mantras, doing rituals and everything. And number two, those who are having Jagat Vyapara, the other sects of humanity, they don't have the burden of executing everything, but in their name, for their benefit, for their development, it is being done by the rishis and brahmanas, by the rituals and other things. So they are not doing anything, they are on the divine base doing anything for the national development, social development, political development, economical development, self-development and domestic governance they are doing. Still they are getting all the benefits that they have to get by their hard work. So without any Herculean bondage and burden, still they are getting all the benefits. That is the essence of the Shastras regarding this thing. So even though the Samskaras are very hard in nature, are observed to be somewhat specific to some members of the society, it is meant for the common well-being, in which somebody, just as Valkyrias are doing sankalpa for those who are engrossed in spiritual service, they are doing all the rites for those who are engrossed in social service and social development. So the society has been balanced and the society has been neutralized without any partiality or without any prejudicial governance of God. God showers his blessings to everybody with equanimity, equity and equality, and he has specially delegated some people to go for the samskaras and do all of this. So this desha, vamsa and jantu and laksha vibhaga is very essential in understanding all of these proportions. And now innumerable samskaras here, they are going to discuss. I don't know how many samskaras we can cover per day. There are innumerable samskaras in which the samskaras which we call as Shodasha Samskara 16 or Ashtadasha Samskara 18, and there are 40 Samskaras, including the 4 Mahavratas called Mahanamni, Mahavrata, then Upanishad and Ashtaka. These are known as 4 Mahavratas. Then there are 7 Havir Yajnas, 7 Paka Yajnas, 7 Homa Yajnas. Soma Yajnas like Atiratra, Shodashi, Vajapaya, they are known as Soma Yajnas. And Dasha Purnamasa and Chatu Masa, those things are known as Havir Yajnas. And Paka Yajna is what we call as Shravani, Shraddha, Parvani, Ashtaka. These things are known as Paka Yajnas, 3 into 7, 21. Then Panchamaha Yajnas, 26. Then 4 Mahavratas, 30. Apart from which I have already told that we are having Garbhadana, we are having Simantonayana, we are having Umsavana, we are having Jatakarma, then Chudakarna, Karnavedi, then Namakarana, Annaprashana, Nishkramana, Vidyarambha, Upanayana, Vivahantyati. These are all the major samskaras, 40 samskaras to give just by name. And in this yuga, how much we can do, how far we can follow these things. I want to say just a very small project. There are 100 crores of citizens in India. If we take 100 people, married couple, there must be a breeding institute. I have given 10 lectures in gynecology at Pune Integral Healthcare Institute. For everything, poultry good breeding is there, fish breeding is there, even for lizards, snakes, everybody, there is an endangering species prevention system and there is a breeding system. But for best breed, there are 3 breeds I have already told. Productive breed, best breed and unique breed. The Shastra says, if you want a productive breed, then the person will be a good follower of your tradition, and he will be a supporter of your successors, and he will be an emancipator of your predecessors. He will uplift them as well as uplift the successors. So those who are very domestically or traditionally binded, they are known as productive breed. Best breed is scientists, good politicians. See, unless we have all, for example, we are having innumerable systems, like excretory system, circulatory system, central nervous system, like that, good industries, good political people, good social animators, good religious heads, unless the religious permeation, unless philosophical perfection, unless spiritual and ethical precision that rules and governs each and every walk or manifestation of human intelligence and performance, we cannot get a benefited society at all. And for getting everybody benefited, there must be a spiritual scintillation. A strong spiritual scintillation should permeate into all divisions of life, all divisions of intelligence and performance, so that it can create radiance, brilliance and effulgence in future. So our project is to take a breeding institute. Unique breed is like the avatar of Ramanujacharya, Shankaracharya, great people, those who are creating mass communication, mega transformation and hyperactive impact in the society, which can last for centuries and millennia. Those people, they are known as unique breed. So your benefit, productive breed. Benefit of a common society or more members, that is best breed. Benefit of the whole universe, which can last long for thousands of years, that is known as unique breed. So these things in Shastras also they used to say. Number one, Anuchara is a person who is well versed in Vedas as well as the other Vedangas. And Shrotriya is a person who is well versed in the Vedas. So person knowledgeable in Vedas, he is known as Shrotriya. And Sikshakalpa Vyakaranita Chanda Dosha, the person is Anuchara. And a person who is capable in Kalpa Sutras, in rituals and applications, the person is known as Rishi Kalpa. And Bruna is a person who is very much capable in Vedic phonetics and applications. And a person who knows the Vedas, Vedangas, Veda Bhakya and Veda Kratu, everything the person knows, he is known as a Rishi. And a person who has gained the power of his knowledge through penance and austerity, he becomes Deva. So according to our VBA, it starts from Shrotriya. Shrotriya, Anuchana, then Rishikalpa, then Bruna, then Rishi and Deva. So that is what, just as now we are calling for a good scientist, we want the bridegroom to be a good doctor, a good engineer, a good auditor. That's what we select for matrimonial purposes and also for academic purposes. Like that, the ancestral traditional selection was, I want my son to be a Shrotriya, to be an Anuchana, to be a Bruna, to be a Rishikalpa, to be a Rishi or to be a Deva. That is the our tradition of expectation or enthusiastic breeding of a child and expecting the child to be blossoming in spiritual realm. These are all the various divisions that is being done. So these type of various samskaras, starting from Garbhadana to the Antyeshti, we should have a different type of, not only institute, we should have a breeding center in which the person, for example, if there is a proper team of driver or pilot, that vehicle reaches the place safely. Hundreds of passengers are carried by one or two pilots in aircrafts, and in ship also the captain and a group of people, the crew, they work for the safe journey of the people, voyage of the people. Like that, for 100 crores of these people, if you take 100 couple having a temple, that is Devashala, having a Yagashala, having a Pakashala, having an Ashvashala, Goshala, Annashala, these are all the components of a divine auditorium or a divine premises. So these 100 people with all the samskaras, they should be selected. There are a lot of people suffering in the society. Those people, their poverty can be a blessing for providing an opportunity. Otherwise, if the person is riding somewhere in Infosys or in Cognizant, those people, they may not give their consent for entering into that ritual or this examination. So this spiritual laboratory in which 100 people at least, they should be developed, they should be incubated with all the samskaras. And I believe that after 2 or 3 decades, the progenical output of this spiritual laboratory, that 100 children, the progeny, they are going to be future guardians of this India. 100 people, well refined, well qualified, hyper potentialized by spiritual wisdom. Because what is your spiritual knowledge?